Now, in the next case, we will be observing the intersection operation carried out on two different paths right over here. So there it goes. This will be the another case here. This is the case 3, intersection between the paths. So if we head back to our Inkscape canvas here, and in the first case, we will be practically drawing any curve, any shape as we wish. We don't need to follow the exact same thing as we have seen in case of that slider there. So we have created this almost a leaf, I think. So I have created a leaf right over here, and the leaf is of course green in color. There it goes. And we will be creating another path here. So we are about to create another path, which is practically another leaf. But this time I'll be adding some different fill and stroke color properties to the second leaf that I have drawn here. So I'll be choosing for, say, this individual maroon color here, and the stroke color, it should be something different like this yellow one. We will be increasing this width here. So we have created both these two individual leaves here. And now if we select both of them, head back to this path intersection, and we can see that the top level leaf is practically gone, as well as the bottom level leaf, and the intersection point between both the leaves, that intersection point, that particular arc is practically residing on right over here, and the bottom level leaf elements, color fill and stroke properties are practically reflected right over here. So this is what exactly how the intersection operation is carried out, and we may do several other tricks with it, but I'll be discussing about the first one here. Have a look into it carefully. First of all, we are heading back to this file, and we are about to unselect this box here that says show page border. So we are unselecting it. Now for say, this is a rectangle. So we have drawn a rectangle first. And on top of it, for say we are drawing a path here, not like this one. Let's make it like this one. So it will be staying as an arc here, a perfect arc. There it goes. And we are practically selecting this outside world here. So there it goes. First of all, I have created an object at the bottom, a rectangle, and then I have created an arc, a path right over here. Now all we need to do, we need to fill some separate color, fill color properties here. So I'll be choosing this yellow one, and I'll be choosing some alternate stroke color to this individual path that I have created. Now all I am going to do, I need to keep this shape right over here and maintain the same intersection properties here. Now, in that particular case, all we can do, first of all, select this bottom leveled element, press Ctrl D to duplicate the bottom leveled rectangle here, and you can see that the bottom leveled rectangle element, on being duplicated, the duplicate part is right now on top of the rest of the elements into our canvas. Now, I'll be selecting this individual rectangle here, this top leveled rectangle here, and I will be choosing the arc path that we had created here. Now, if we head back to this path, and if we now choose this intersection, we can see practically in this particular case where the intersection operation was carried out, the bottom leveled element was the path that we had created. Remember? And the topmost part was the duplicated rectangle here. And we can see that the same arc which was practically intersecting, we can see that the same arc is now remaining, is now residing right over here. Now one may contradict this part. It might be said, it might be a little bit of confusion that What about if we do the same exact thing by first of all creating this individual rectangle here, then we grab our paint tool, and then all we are going to do, we are going to create an arc right over here, hit enter. First of all, this is another box here, this is another path, and then we are completing it. And right now, if we change this color into something else, into something different, then the same exact thing can be drawn right over here. But in that particular case, it will be a possible easier thing to match all these individual edges into our document, into our Inkscape canvas document. So it is better to stick into the first method. So this will be the obvious path. First of all, create that individual rectangle right over here. Then you need to create that arc path or the path of the curve that you wish to work on, and it will be proper into the edges, as we can see right over here. This is the easiest and this is the convenient method in drawing any kind of overlaying arc elements, arc properties here, to create different shades of an individual object. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.